Good morning, students. Today we are going to see representing irrational numbers on number line. Okay. So irrational numbers. We have already learned about the types of numbers. In that, we learned rational numbers and irrational numbers. Okay. So rational numbers means what? The numbers which we can represent it into the which form? P by Q form. Correct. Means the decimal expansion of that such a number is of which type? Terminating decimal expansion or terminate, not terminating but recurring, right? Means that numbers are written as rational numbers. Rational numbers means the decimal expansion is terminating, means the division will stop after decimal point. After carrying out the specific places, the division will stop. Means you will get the remainder 0, correct? Means decimal expansion is terminating. Or which type of expansion? Not terminating but recurring. Non terminating means division will never stop. Okay, so you have to be, you will carry out the division again and again. The division will never stop. And recurring or we can say that repetitive. Repetitive means what? After the decimal point, the specific group of number is going to repeat again and again. It means that the specific group of the digit will repeat again and again, but division will not stop. So such a number means which type of number? Non-terminating recurring or non-terminating repetitive. Okay, so these numbers are called which type of number? Rational number. So we can express such a number into the form of P by Q, where Q is not equal to 0, right? So irrational numbers means what? So irrational numbers means the decimal expansion of such a number is non-terminating, non-recurring. Non-terminating means division will never stop. Okay, division will never stop, and non-terminating and non-recurring means specific group of number. After the decimal point, the specific group of numbers means digit cannot occur again and again. Means, for example, suppose we have taken that x equals to one of the number that 0.20200200002000002 and so on, right? Means again now here 10 there, 20, 3 zeros are there, 4 zero, correct? After this 5 zeros will come, then 2, then 6 zero will come, and then means that continuously process is going on, right? Means this decimal expansion is which type? Is that the division is stop? No. Division is not stop. Means how we can understand division is not stop? Means we have given the result. Means division will not stop. Means non-terminating and non-repetitive. That supposed to be 0.125125125 like this, and ... means we can write, or we can represent this number into form of 125 bar, correct? Means here we can say that the specific group digit means specific group of the digit 125 is repeated, correct? Here specific group of this digit is repeated, so here we can say that non-terminating but repeated, or non-terminating but recurring numbers, correct? But in this case, what happens? After decimal point, are we getting here the specific group of digits is repeating? No, because the digits are different. 0.20, that 0 will come one time, then 2 will come again. But 00 will come 2 times, then 2, 00 will come 3 times, like this, so this will carry out. Okay, so here, specific, like this specific group of digits, here there is no specific group of digits. Okay, so this expansion, this decimal expansion is which type? Non-terminating, means continuously going on, right? Non-terminating and non-recurring, or we can say non-repetitive. This group of the digits is non-recurring or non-repetitive. Okay, so such a type of examples are such a type of number. See here, another number is what? 1, 2, 1, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, then 1. How many times? 2 is there? 4 times, then 5 times, then again 1 will come, नॉन टर्मिनेटिंग एंड नॉन रिपीटिंग. सो सच अ डेसिमल एक्सपेंशन ऑफ दैट नंबर आर कॉल्ड डिसाइड ऑफ नंबर इरेगुलर नंबर. ओके सो द नंबर दिस टाइप ऑफ नंबर वी कैन नॉट एक्सप्रेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाय क्यू. ओके सो सच नंबर्स आर कॉल्ड इरेगुलर नंबर्स. अंडरस्टूड एवरीवन? Now we will see how to represent the irrational numbers or number lines. Okay. Okay. Suppose I have to represent first number root 2. Okay. Then another number is supposed to be root 3 on the number line. So I will represent this root 2 and root 3 on the same number line. Okay.
So to represent this root 2 on a number line, so we will see how to represent that two root 2 on a number line. Okay, so for that, first we will draw a line on blackboard. Okay, here draw a number line. Correct. Now represent with these two arrow on both sides. Then take up any point O or take any point O which represent 0. Correct. That represent 0. And we have to take one unit distance in your compass. Okay. We have to take one unit distance in your compass. So you can take suppose to be a 2 cm or 3 cm or 4 cm as a 1 unit distance. That you have to keep in mind, because again afterwards vertical distances we have to take as a 1 unit or 2 unit. Okay, so according to that you have to keep in mind. If you are taking that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 cm distances or 6 cm distances in your compass as a 1 unit, so you have to keep in mind that. Okay, so take particular distance in your compass supposed to be here. The distance I have taken, so it is 1 unit distance. Okay, this is my 1 unit distance. Okay, so now this is my point A which represent 1 unit distance. Okay, afterwards from this point A we have to draw a perpendicular from this point A which is given on number line. So we have already learned how to draw a perpendicular from the given point on a number line. Okay, so we will draw this perpendicular. Now what we have to do for the same, take any convenient distance in your compass and keep one end of your compass on the point A. Then do the arc on both sides of your point A. Okay. Then next step is what? This new arc you got, this point, this arc and this arc. So we have to adjust more than half distance from these two arc. Okay. So more than half distance means this is whole distance. More than half means little less, means this is the more than half distance from these two arc. These two arc there and this is the more than half distance. Understood? So from this first arc we have to make the arc on upside and here down, means from this arc. Similarly from the downside also we will do. Okay. Now, adjust these three, means this point of intersections of these two arcs on up and down side, and this is your point A. Okay. Draw a line. So there is no need to draw down side. We can draw up till this only, because we want the perpendicular from this point A. So perpendicular means what? Of course here how many degree angle? 90 degree angle. Okay. Again next step we have to take then the same distance which we have adjusted for this point OA, that is the 1 unit distance. This we have to adjust in your compass. This is 1 unit distance. Okay. And the same distance we have to take on this perpendicular. Okay. And to make the arc which cut this perpendicular. Right. Next step is what we have done here. We have adjusted the distance between this OA and from the point A we have made the arc on your perpendicular. Okay. Which cut the distance of OA distance. Okay. Then next here we will take this point supposed to be B. Right. Now we will draw this line or we will join this O and B. Okay. We will join this O and B. So what is this distance we have taken? That is 1 unit. Okay. This is also 1 unit. Then what about this distance? Can we say that how much distance it is? We can find this distance by using. So here this figure we got OAB. So which type of this triangle? Yes, this is which type of triangle? Rectangle triangle. So we will use to find out this which theorem? Pythagoras theorem. Correct. So now we will take this triangle. In triangle, this triangle OAB. Okay. OAB. Which what is the perpendicular? BA is a perpendicular to OA. Okay. BA is perpendicular to OA. So because of that angle OAB is 90 degree. Angle OAB equals to 90 degree. And so we are using Pythagoras theorem to find out the OB distances. Okay. So here by Pythagoras theorem, what will be there? Pythagoras theorem, what will be there? OB square equals to, what is OB square equals to? OA square plus BA square, correct? OA square plus BA square. So what is OA? 1 square. Okay, then BA is 1, that is square. So 1 square is 1 plus 1 square is 1, that is 2. So you got here OB square equals to 2. But we want OB or OB square? We want OB, correct? So OB, the square root of OB square is OB. Then what is the square root of 2? Is the 2 is the perfect square of any number? No. So we can take this square root of this number is what? Root 2, correct? So this is your root 2 distance. Okay, so root 2 we got in this manner. Okay, but your number line is this. So we want this distance on number line. Right? So for that, what we will do? We will adjust this distance in your compass, that OB distance. Adjust OB distance in your compass. Okay? And make the arc. Means take O as a center and OB is the radius. After adjusting your OB distances, O is the center and OB is the radius. Draw the circular, means semicircular type arc from this point. Okay. So now this point is your A1. Correct. So A1 represent what is the distance? Root 2. Now this root 2, we have taken this root 2 distance on this number line. So O A dash. Now your O A dash or O A1 we have taken here is your root 2 distance. Okay. Understood. Now we have to represent again root 3 on the same number line. So same step we will carry out here, whatever we have done here as a point on A. So same from point A1 we have to draw the perpendicular. Okay, so same procedure we will adjust any one of the distance from point A1. We will make the new two arcs for the perpendicular, that you know that everyone how to draw a perpendicular from the given point on number line. So make the little long arc so we can identify which one new arcs are there, because already here arcs are there, correct? So now again, after drawing these two arc, you have to take the more than half distance, or we have to adjust the more than half distance from these two arc. Getting everyone? More than half distances from these two new arc, we are taking more than half distance. Okay, now from this point we have to make this arc, and from this point or from this arc we have to make the new arc. Okay, and now we have to join this point A1 and this new point. Understood everyone? Now what is the next step will be here? This distance of one unit we have taken, before only one unit we have taken the distance on this vertical or on this perpendicular. So same step we have to carry out here. Okay, so this again we will take this distance as the one unit distance. See here, this arc of one unit distance. So same one unit distance we will take from this point A1 and on this perpendicular. Understood everyone? What we have done? This AB distance we have adjusted here, that is one unit, before only we have taken. So same distance we will take from point now A1 and on this perpendicular. So we will cut out this arc that represent the distance between this A1 and this arc is how many unit? One unit distance. Okay, afterwards we have to join this O to this new point. I will represent this new point with the B dash. Okay, now join this B dash and your O. Understood everyone? Now what will be the next step? Yes, this distance is of this O A1 is root 2 distances. Okay, afterwards here this A B dash is 1. Okay, now when you will join this O B dash, you will get O A1 B dash is your new one right angle triangle. Okay, so now in this triangle, now we will take in triangle, this triangle O A1 B dash, O A1 B dash. Here what is, which angle is 90 degree angle? O A1 B dash angle O A1 B dash equals to how many degree? 90 degree. So again we will use here Pythagoras theorem and we will find out what is the OB dash distance. Okay, so in this triangle OA1 B dash is 90 degree. So again we will use this theorem, of course here Pythagoras theorem, correct? So what will be the, according to the Pythagoras theorem statement, OB dash square, OB dash square is equals to OA1 square, OA1 square plus which one next? A1 B dash, right? A1 B dash square. Now what is the OA1 distance? OA1 distance is root 2. Okay, so root 2 square plus A1 B dash. A1 B dash means how many distance we have taken? That is 1 unit. So it is 1 square. So what is the root 2 square? Always any root number square is that number itself. Okay, so root 2 square is only 2 will come. Suppose root 5 square is that 5 will come. Root 7 square is that 7 will come. Okay, so always any root number square is that number itself plus 1. So you got here 3. O B dash square you got 3. But we want O B dash, correct na? So O B dash equals to what is here? Root 3. Okay, so this distance is what represent this distance? Root 3. Correct? Now this distance is here root 3, but we want root 3 distances on number line. So again, what is the next step will be there? Yes, correct. This next step will be that we have to adjust OB dash distance in your compass. Correct? We have to adjust OB dash distances in your compass. Okay? And I have adjusted here this OB dash distance. Okay? Afterwards, take O is the center and OB dash is the radius and draw the arc which okay, so this is the distance that A2. This A2 distance means O A2 distance is represent how many distance? Root 3. Understood everyone? So in this way, again we have to follow the same step from this point. Again we have to take another point here A2, then here A3, A4 like this. Means you will get the another distances like root 3, then afterwards root 4, root 5, root 6, root 7. So continuously you have to follow such a step. Understood everyone? Next we will see the existence of a square root of positive real number. Okay. So everyone knows that positive real numbers, correct? So now for this existence of the square root of the positive real number on number line, so we will take that one example. Represent root 9.3 on the number line. Okay, so how to represent 9.3, root 9.3 on a number line. How to represent the root 9.3 on a number line? We have to take a 9.3 distances on a number line. First, we have to take 9.3. Okay. Suppose this is my distance is 9.3 distance on a number line. Okay. So here I will take this A, B. So this is 9.3. AB equals to 9.3 centimeter distance on number line. So in this case, when you will take one as an AB equals to 9.3 centimeter, means whatever distance it is given here, root 9.3. Then you have to take 9.3 on the number line, or you have to draw a line which represents the distance 9.3 centimeter. At the same time, you have to add 1 centimeter. Means at the same time, you have to add 1 centimeter distance in this 9.3. Okay. Suppose this is my 1 centimeter distance, this B2 C, that new one point is C, which is 1 centimeter distance. So actually totally how many centimeter distance that AC? AC is 9.3 plus 1, that is 10.3 centimeter distance. Okay, so what we have to do? First, whatever here given, that distance we have to take as an AB distance is that 9.3 centimeter. Then we have to reduce AB to point C such as BC equals to 1 centimeter. Okay, so total distance is now how much? 10.3 distances. Okay, afterwards the next step is what we have to, means here I will write this first step, this 9.3 centimeter plus 1 centimeter, that is total distance of this is AB plus BC equals to here 10.3 centimeter, that is your distance is AC, right? Then second step, in that we have to draw the perpendicular bisector of AC. Okay, so you have to draw perpendicular bisector of AC. This actually, these two steps once you understood, then you can do. Okay, so when you will draw the perpendicular bisector, what to do? We have to take more than half distance of your AC distance, correct? So we will draw this perpendicular bisector for this AC. From point A, we will draw the arc on up and down. Okay, similarly from the downside, right? From point C, we will follow the same step. Correct? Then join this. You have to join this arc as distances of this. Okay. Right, this is the perpendicular bisector of AC. Now I will give your name. This is O. Okay. Understood everyone? After taking 9.3 plus 1 distances, 1 centimeter distance, that AB plus BC, then next step is what? Draw the perpendicular bisector of AC. Okay. So that AC divides into two equal parts. Then afterwards we have to adjust. Third step is we have to adjust OC and OA distances in your compass. Okay. OC and OA distance in your compass. Understood everyone? Next step is what? Take O as a center and adjust the OC and OA distance exactly in your compass. Understood everyone? And then draw the semicircular arc which passes through the point A and C. Okay, this passes through the A and C. Understood everyone? What we have to do? Next step is, after drawing the perpendicular bisector of AC, we have to take O as a center, adjust OC and OA distance in your compass, and to draw the arc means to draw the semicircular arc. Okay, or to draw a semicircle which passes through the point A and C. Okay, then next step is here the same. We have to draw the from the point B, we have to draw the perpendicular. Okay, we have to draw perpendicular from point B. So for that purpose, we will draw, or we will follow the step to draw perpendicular from the point on number line. Okay, so take any convenient distance in your compass, take B as a center and make the arc on both sides. Got everyone? From the point B, we have to draw a perpendicular. So we can select any one of the distance in your compass. Keep the one end of your compass on point B. Make the arc on both sides. What is the next step? Adjust the more than half distance from these two arcs. This is our two arcs. So more than half distance means little less. Correct? So, and afterwards from these two arcs, we have to draw this arc for the perpendicular. Okay. Then join these two arcs which intersect your semicircular arc. Like this we have to join. Okay. Now perpendicular from this point B, which intersect your semicircular at point, suppose this D. Okay. So this distance is OD. Sorry, this distance is BD is your root 9.3. BD is your okay, then this BD, we have to join this BD point means then after giving this new point we got here B which intersect perpendicular from the point B which intersect this semicircle at point D. Now what we will do, we have to join this OD distance. Okay, we have to join this OD distance, right? Next step, take the BD distance or at least the BD distance, that is your BD distance we have to take in a compass, adjust in a compass, and we have to draw the semicircular arc, or we have to draw the arc. Okay, this distance BD we have to adjust in your compass and take B as a center and BD as a radius and draw this arc, circular type arc. Okay, now we have to extend this line AC okay, so now this point will give the name E, right? And this E represent which distance root 9.3 on number line. This OE distance, that point E represent 9.3 centimeter distance or 9.3 that number or number line. Okay, so this OE represent root 9.3 on a radius, that E represent root 9.3 on a number line. Understood everyone?